Hey, this is Nico Carver, NebulaPhotos.com. The purpose of this video is just to let you know how I'm going to handle reviews on this channel, since I just started publishing my first reviews today. You can read the whole policy written out on my website, and the link is in the description. Okay, first point, I will never review a product on this channel for money. Let me repeat that. I'll never review a product on this channel for money. Meaning, if a company approaches me and says, we want you to review this camera on your channel, we'll pay you $2,000, we want you to say these things about it, that's an easy and automatic no for me. I am only interested in unbiased reviews where I get to say whatever I want and I'm not being compensated for the review. Now, this doesn't mean I will never accept money from a company in what's called a brand deal. The difference there is there's things on YouTube, which I'm sure you've seen, called sponsored videos or a paid promotion, as they call them sometimes. I'm open to doing these if my channel gets big enough and I get approached, but those are very clearly ads. YouTube even has a little disclaimer that you can add to the video, and I would, that says includes paid promotion. I'm sure you've seen these on YouTube channels and at the beginning of every podcast. And I don't think they're wrong. They're just ads. They allow creators to actually make a living making videos or podcasts or whatever they want. So to sum up my first point, I will never do a paid review where I'm told what to say for a fee, but I reserve the right to do very clearly marked sponsored videos in the future. The second point is all about free stuff. And I put free stuff in quotes because I have companies emailing me all the time now offering to send me products for a review on this channel. And of course, this isn't really free at all because they're just trying to trade a copy of their product for exposure on YouTube. And I'd actually be doing the work of reviewing it, so it's really just like a trade. And most of the time, you don't get to keep the product anyways, especially with the more expensive products like a lens or a camera. You send it back after you do your review or after you've had it for a while. So I have no ethical problem with this, of accepting a loan of a product for free if it fits with something that I actually want to do on the channel. But so far, about 99% of the email I get doesn't fit with what I want to do. So I just say no, because it doesn't make sense for me to show you some like monopod or a video light or a watch or whatever they're offering. So far I've only accepted two products on loan for review. In both cases, the companies were fine with me taking my time and will have no say over what I put into any reviews that I do of these items. I have a long-term loan of this QHY-168C, which I've used in a few videos, most recently to test light pollution filters. So thank you very much to QHY for this long-term loan. I also hope to do a review of the camera itself as a standalone video. And the only other product I've accepted is this fisheye lens from TT Artisan, because I want to do a shootout review of a bunch of fisheye lenses, and I hope to have that video out really soon. So to sum up the second point, I will only accept free stuff from companies if they don't tell me what to say and it fits with some video that I'm already interested in doing. I also usually send this stuff back to them. I don't keep it. Now, some people may consider accepting a product from a company in exchange for a review a form of bias. Like, if I'm accepting the product, do I have to give it a good review? And to be clear, I don't think so. If a company did indicate that was a condition of loaning me something, that it had to be a good review, then I wouldn't accept it, because I'm only interested in an unbiased review, warts and all. Third and final point is about disclaimers and disclosures. The idea here is just to be very transparent about everything I'm doing. So I've always had a disclaimer on my website and in my YouTube video descriptions explaining that I do what is called affiliate marketing. Basically, just if you use my link to buy something at Amazon or OPT, then I get a small commission from those companies, and it's paid out monthly, all the commissions. But your price doesn't go up. It's just a marketing, and that it gets you to buy something on their site. Similarly, anytime I'm using something that I've been given on loan, I'm going to disclose that in the video and on my websites. Okay, hopefully all of this made sense and it's not controversial. Many other YouTubers have had to think through these things too and define a policy for themselves. And I'm basically just sharing that whole policy and my thought process with you. I don't see any reason why this would ever have to change, but if I do have to change the policy in the future, I'm going to make it very clear on the website with a change log how I'm changing it. And if I radically change it for some reason, I don't think that'll happen, I'll also record a new video explaining my reasoning. Okay, till next time, clear skies, everyone.